The roots of pathology are believed to have evolved in the Middle East during the Islamic Golden Age and in Western Europe during the Italian Renaissance. Most early pathologists were also practicing physicians or surgeons. From the Greek roots pathos, meaning experience or suffering, and logia, meaning study of. Hence, pathology is a medical specialty that is concerned with the diagnosis of disease based on the laboratory analysis of body fluids and tissues. Rudolf Virchow is generally acknowledged as the father of microscopic pathology. In India, Dr. Vasant Ramji Karnolkar is recognized as the father of pathology and medical research.
Pathology is the science of the abnormal. Now, we study the normal first, and then we study the abnormal. And that is why pathologist's job is to study the normal and then to see what is abnormal in that patient and interpret, which is of prime importance in all pathology reports.
In a clinical management of patients, we come across various aspects of management. Initially, the physicians look after the patients, they examine the patient, they take history. After that comes the investigation, the next step. So the diagnostic management of it. And third part is the therapeutic, which is called the treatment modality. So these three phases are very important in any patient's management. So we come at the middle phase, where the diagnostic management needs to be done. So what happens when we talk about clinico-pathological correlation is the combination of all these three aspects to come to a conclusion, whether the treatment was right, the diagnosis, that inference that we took was right. Now here, what is needed is the interaction between the clinician, who is the doctor, who is taking care of the patient, and the pathologist, who is taking care of behind the, as a back office, managing the diagnostic part of it. So when they interact with each other, you get an answer to the issues which the patient is facing.
With the tremendous development in modern science, the field of pathology has evolved significantly.
So pathology is, as such, is a very, very vast branch, and it has various subspecialties. They come under the tree of a pathology. So such as a clinical pathology, then you have a cytopathology, and you have a histopathology, then hematopathology. Blood banking also included under pathology. One more branch was included in the pathology, that is biochemistry branch. Nowadays, it is institutional level, it is termed as a separate branch as a biochemistry. But still, in practice, it comes under a pathology branch. In our body, there are various body cavities, such as we have in a brain, there is a space in between the brain and outer membrane. Then we have our abdomen, there is a space to accumulate the fluid. And in the pleural cavities, that is in the lung and outer rib cage, there is a cavity. So when the fluid accumulates in these cavities, that fluid has to be tapped and taken out for the examination to find out what is the cause of that accumulation of fluid in those cavities. So all the fluid examination, they come under the clinical pathology. Then you have a urine examination, which is the most simplest way of examination by which we can diagnose many diseases by doing the simple test. That also comes under the clinical pathology. Cytopathology is a branch where you can study the cells. Like, we have our body parts, or each body organ is composed of various cells. So if you take out the cells, and it is a non-invasive test, like if you want to test the tissue, we have to, patient has to undergo operation and find a, taking out the piece of that tissue, and then you have to examine. But cytopathology, very simplest procedure, which is done in the OPD level, in the laboratory itself, and just you have to, with the syringe and needle, put into that organ and take out, aspirate it. Means you just suck that area so that some kind of cells, they come into the syringe, and we examine that cell, those cells, to know what kind of disease process is in that area of the tissue. So that is a cytopathology. Coming to hematopathology, hematopathology is a branch where you study the blood cells or study of blood. So as you all know, the blood contains the various cells, like you have a red blood cells, white blood cells, and you have a platelets. So when you study the hematopathology, we study all three kinds of cells. What is abnormality? What is the causes of increased cells? What is the causes of decreased cells? So we do the counts of their cells as well as, so there is a quantitative as well as qualitative examination, all the components of blood. That is hematopathology. Histopathology, we have to take out the piece of that tissue or body part, where suppose there is a tumor. So we take out those part, that small bit of that, and we examine. There is a lot of process involved in it. In the laboratory, it takes 3 days to make the glass slide on that tissue on the glass slide to examine under the microscopes. So that is a histopathology, and all kinds of diseases is that diagnosed by histopathology.
Pathologists play a very important and essential role in diagnosis. Let us understand from a treating doctor how a pathologist and his report make a difference in treatment of a patient.
Whenever a patient comes to us, we have 4 to 5 differential diagnoses which a clinician has as a initially. But to come at an exact diagnosis, the role of pathologist is very important, because you have to narrow down to one diagnosis and accordingly treat it. So the pathologist's role for making the accurate diagnosis, and ultimately the whole treatment depends on the diagnosis.
Diagnosis part of a clinician has got 3 aspects. The first, a patient comes with some symptoms. He analyzes those symptoms, then he takes his history, and all this history and his symptoms are one part. The second aspect, he examines him physically. And that examination, like he's taking his temperature, his pulse, his blood pressure, or maybe auscultating or percussing this thing, palpating his abdomen and other things. All these things are the second part of his clinical examination. With these two, he forms an opinion, a working diagnosis. Like the patient may be having something. Suppose a patient comes with fever. So this may be a typhoid fever or a malaria fever or some tuberculosis. He thinks about that, and that is called a differential diagnosis. So to differentiate between two diagnoses, he needs the third aspect. And third aspect, that third thing is provided by these pathology laboratories and other investigations. So to complete the diagnosis, the laboratory tests are really, really essential. Without that, no diagnosis can be confirmed.
In the field of medicine, pathology laboratory plays a vital role.
Laboratory is a place where all the tests are carried out with the help of machines. These machines are very, very sensitive and very good machines. And nowadays, a lot of data is being thrown out of these machines. But it is important to interpret those machines. And that is the job of a pathologist. Just data is no use to the clinician. He's not a pathologist. The pathologist is supposed to see that data and interpret with the age of the patient, whether it's a baby, a child, a woman, or a man. And that will make all the difference to the interpretation of that data.
So laboratory, in our perspective, means we are actually trying to analyze those tissue or the fluids and get an answer to the problems faced by the patient.
In these laboratories, pathologists are assisted by laboratory technicians to carry out procedures.
Once the blood is collected from the patient, it has to be processed. It has to be processed in some way to be put or presented to the machine. So that is the job of a technician, to collect the sample properly, because if it's wrongly collected, you will have wrong reports. They are important. They help you in the laboratory. They see that the machines are run properly. They are supposed to run the controls and the standards and bring out those in front of the pathologist to say that today's standard and controls are these. Should we proceed with the whole batch? So the technician's job is mainly collection, processing, feeding the material in the machines, taking out the data, and it should be presented to the pathologist for proper interpretation.
To ensure accurate diagnosis, it is necessary that these doctors must be specialists in the field of pathology and must acquire significant and relevant educational degrees from recognized medical schools, residencies, and possibly fellowships, along with proper registration.
One who has done his basic graduation in medicine, that is MBBS, has to pursue further study in the subject of pathology, either a diploma or a degree, postgraduate degree, he can become a pathologist. There are two options. One is a 3-year full-time MD postgraduate degree in pathology, or 1.5 to 2 years course of a diploma, DPP. Previously it used to be called DCP, Diploma in Clinical Pathology. The standard colleges are one which are run by the government or the corporations. Like in Mumbai, we have 3 corporation colleges, KEM, Nair, Sion, and 1 government college, JJ. Pune has BJ Medical, Nagpur has GMC. Nowadays, there are some private colleges also, deemed university status or otherwise.
Like pathologists, the technicians working under them also need to be professionally trained.
A basic course is BSc, and after that, 2 years course, which is conducted by medical colleges. Nowadays, there are DMLT courses after 12th also, after 10th also. 1 year course is there, half year. Even you will find many correspondence courses are there. But the main course is after BSc. It is a 2 year course. It is run in medical colleges, and the degree is given by recognized universities.
To monitor and maintain the standards of medical education and conduct of doctors, there are some government bodies.
MCI stands for Medical Council of India, which has come into the existence by a Parliament Act of 1956. And MMC is Maharashtra Medical Council, which came into existence in 1965 by an act of the legislature of the Maharashtra. The roles are respectively MCI has to give recognition to the medical colleges and different medical courses. It will also hear the cases which are coming to them in appeal after a judgment given by the state council. The MCI also will be doing a very important function of prescribing the code of conduct and etiquettes. The Maharashtra Medical Council or other state councils will be doing first registration, second renewal, third hearing of cases, and giving penalties to the doctor who are found to be negligent.
Along with the government bodies, there are non-government organizations in India who are also actively working for the betterment in medical fraternity.
IMA is Indian Medical Association. It's a 3-tier system. Headquarters, that is Delhi, state office, and state branches. So we got, at headquarters, we got about 2,80,000 and more members at present. At state level, Maharashtra state, we are having 40,000 members. It is the highest members in a country. So we are having 208 branches in all over Maharashtra. And the modern medicine, that means MBBS and above, that means MD medicine, MS, general surgery, these are the members of, eligible members of Indian Medical Association. Pathologists are there, MD, that is the MBBS and MD, even MBBS and diploma pathology, they can become a member of IME.
We look after the academic things about the our doctors. Then, he has to update his knowledge, so we provide all the updates in every aspect of medicine. Then, secondly, there are so many medical legal problems. There are so many court cases which are done. There are so many problems with the doctors. Sometimes the problems with the patients, problems with the practice. So these things are done by IME.
IAPM is our national body of pathology, that is Indian Association of Pathologists and Microbiologists. It is formed nearly more than 65 years, and every year that IAPM body, lot of activities are taken place under which, and mainly it's an educational purpose. So students which are doing pursuing a post-graduation in a pathology as a specialty, they have to present a paper, because as per the MCI norms, they have to present their published work or their research work in these conferences or under this association. Lot of ethical issues are being discussed in these conferences, so that students are taught what is the ethical practice about the pathology.
role of pathologist and laboratory remains same universally. But are the standards of maintaining labs and the protocols to be followed by pathologists and technicians in India the same as global standards?
Whereas in Western world, what has happened is that these areas of, say, accreditation or training or laying out guidelines or recognizing has been given or sort of outsourced, or possibly they are self-monitored by groups, professional bodies such as CAP. CAP is basically a College of American Pathologists. This is a group by the pathologist, for the pathologist, and consists of the pathologist. So what this group does is that they get together, they have brought out guidelines how to run a lab, how to do a test, how the trainings need to be done. So they have come out with their guidelines, and they also accredited whether you have attended the trainings. No? So they certify you. And this also gets transformed in that sense that they also are into accreditation. So they accredit the labs also. Apart from that, they also take care of the quality aspects of it by providing proficient testing materials. So you can compare each and every lab. Now that whole system is lacking in India. We don't have a professional body which has been recognized by government of India or the state government, which has been given that power of managing and taking care of the laboratory aspects in the community.
In the Indian scenario, working pathologists are facing few problems with regards to their profession. Are there any do's and don'ts in this field?
The first thing you have to see is what are the do's for the general public, the do's for the pathologists, and do's for the government or for the administration in general. So when you look at that, the do's for the administration is to make sure that the rule of the law is enforced. In any condition, we say rule of the law. And what does the law say? The law says that every pathology laboratory should be run by a qualified and registered pathologist. Definition of the pathologist is somebody who has done MBBS and then has a postgraduate qualification in pathology, that is an MD, a diploma in pathology, or a DNB in pathology. So any of these three categories of people are qualified to run and manage and certify reports from a pathology laboratory. So rule of law from that point of view is that the government should ensure that the laws which are in place should be diligently followed, and those who are not obeying that law, they should be punished as per the law. If there is some loophole in the law, then the government should close those loopholes by either amending the existing laws or getting in new laws which will make sure that the law is watertight. From point of view of pathologist has a duty to the patient, because in the eyes of the law, in the eyes of the council, in the eyes of the patient, for the pathologist or for the patient, the pathologist is the one who is looking at the sample, monitor its entire course through the laboratory, and authenticate the report. So he also should make sure that he is physically present in the laboratory and monitor everything. He should not be away from the lab and reports coming out from his name.
But this perception is not there, and generally what happens, we see many of the hospitals, there are in-house side laboratories which are run by technicians or DMLTs or equivalent persons, or they may not have qualification, and they have learned these things by attending some laboratories, and they start operating there. So these types of labs are working under supervision of clinicians or under the roof of clinicians as a hospital side lab. Second part is that these technicians, they know the technical things, but they are not authorized to run the laboratory. They start their own laboratory independently, and they approach the doctor and ask them to refer the patients for blood investigations. Then third type, these technicians, they know the rules and regulations. They are little bit fear about the rules and regulations, and they definitely know ki if I get caught, I'll be punished. Then what they find midway is that they hire the signature from some pathologist. So if at all there is some problem, on paper it appears that a pathologist is there, but pathologist is not actually there. These persons, either with his permission or without his permission, they take the signature. It is very easy to scan the signatures. It is very easy to get registration number, name, from the websites and from the Google, and use it without my knowledge also. Some of the pathologists, some of the black sheeps in our field, they join hands with these technicians and they say that you use my name, you use my signatures, you use my rubber stamp for you, your this thing, and you give some amount to me monthly or whatever it may be.
Medical profession is considered as the noblest profession. According to the World Health Organization, every citizen, be it in any country, has a right to get scientific and standardized healthcare facilities. If body fluids and tissues are improperly tested and wrongly reported, they may cause huge damage to public health in totality.
At midnight, I given a report of malaria positive. But that patient was highly parasitized with malaria parasite. The parasitemic count was very high. So I told my boy to check in the morning whether the patient is alive or he is shifted. The patient died next morning. I gone to the records, the patient's record, and came to know that 2 days before, the patient was given vital test positive and malaria negative. The vital test is done for typhoid, detection of typhoid disease. So that those reports misled the doctor, and ultimately the wrong report was given, the wrong treatment was given. After these incidences, illegal laboratories, laboratory reports, patient are suffering, patient have economical losses. Then a few pathologists and microbiologists come together and started a state level association in the name of Maharashtra Association of Practicing Pathologists and Microbiologists. The main aim of this association was to fight against the illegal laboratories, follow the issue with the state government, follow the issue with district level bogus doctor committees, follow the issue in, if required, in the court. So we started working since 2006. After that, we got order of Bombay High Court in Public Interest Litigation 28/2005 on 10-10-2007. After that, we took this order to the state government, and we were following that to implement that order so that the illegal laboratories will be stopped. During the implementation, we got very good act, that is Right of Information Act. We used this act extensively. Almost more than 3,000 RTI applications were filed by us. These were filed to the state government as well as district bogus doctor samitis, the tehsil bogus doctor samitis, and through this we could get a survey of almost 2/3 of Maharashtra.
The Maharashtra Association of Practicing Pathologists and Microbiologists, through its various members, has always tried to expose these wrong practices that are happening in law. We have numerous examples. For example, we had a laboratory in Khargar where a technician was running the laboratory and he was using the registration number. He was calling himself a doctor and he was using the registration number of a qualified and registered pathologist who was practicing in Kolhapur. Now we investigated this matter and we found out, and finally we complained to the police. The entire laboratory was shut down. All the material inside was seized and a case is running in the court. Similarly, there was a lab in Panvel where the pathologist was actually based out in Jalgaon, and his name was being used in Panvel and he had no idea about it. So when we informed him, he came out over here, and using the help of the association, we have complained against this laboratory. Then there was one laboratory in Airoli where the doctor was in Bijapur. He was teaching in a medical college in Bijapur, the pathologist, and his name was over here. And to add to it, there was a 50 rupees emergency charge. So you could get a report in half an hour, 50 rupees extra for that, and the doctor's not in town. So again, this was exposed by MAPPM. And the point we want to make is that everybody has to contribute to make sure such illegal laboratories have to be shut down.
मी राहणार परभणीचा आणि माझ्या पत्नीच्या डिलिव्हरीचे दिवस असल्याकारणाने मी तपासणीसाठी डॉक्टरांकडे गेलो होतो रक्त तपासणीसाठी. त्यावेळेस मला असं सांगण्यात आलं की तुम्हाला ह्या लॅबला जाऊन रिपोर्ट्स घ्यावे लागतील, तुमच्या तपासण्या कराव्या लागतील. तसं मी त्यांनी सांगितलेल्या लॅबला गेलो, तिथं तपासणी केल्या. तपासणी केल्यानंतर मला असं जाणवलं की ते मुलं मला रिपोर्ट्स दिले, सगळे दिले, पण डॉक्टर कोणीच भेटला नाही. त्यांना विचारलं हे रिपोर्ट्स कोणी बनवले, तर ते मुलं म्हणत होते की मीच बनवलेले आहेत. मी बनवली म्हणजे मी म्हणलं डॉक्टर साहेबांना भेटायचं होतं तर ते सांगत नव्हते तसे डॉक्टर कोण आहेत काय ते रिपोर्ट्स साईन केलेले मी तसेच घेतले आणि मी त्या डॉक्टरांनाकडे दिलं ज्यांनी मला पाठवलं होतं त्यांच्याकडे तर तेही बरोबर उत्तर देत नव्हते तेव्हा मला असं जाणवायला लागलं की हे कुठंतरी चुकीचं होतं.
इफ अ पेशंट गोज टू डॉक्टर अँड डॉक्टर ask him certain investigations are required for you and you need to do these investigations for diagnosis or for knowing the prognosis of the patient, then immediately the question of patient is that doctor where should I do these investigations. He cannot understand the difference between technician's laboratory, between bogus laboratory and qualified pathologist laboratory, and doctor sometimes take the advantage of that only. And that is the beginning of wrong practices.
Thane pathologist was born in 2013 with the intention that we will have some continuous medical education program and as well as a legal fight against this illegal pathology laboratories. And for that purpose we complained to Maharashtra Medical Council where some of our pathologists who are signing at not less than 25 to 30 places. So how it is possible for a single person to move here and there for all such distance? So these signatures are fake.
Pathologists and their associations who are raising voice against the unethical practices in the field of pathology are disappointed with the passive and indecisive role of the government.
Government has issued certain GRs as well as circulars. According to these GRs, bogus doctor committees are formed. There is a district level bogus doctor committee under the chairmanship of collector, district health officer, civil surgeon, SP, FDA officer. All these are members of this committee. In the municipal corporation, the committee is under the chairmanship of municipal commissioner. There are also health officers as well as police. In tehsil level, that committee is under the chairmanship of tehsildar. According to the guidelines for these committees, they are expected to check each and every clinical establishment in their jurisdiction. They should check the certificates of the doctors or certificate of the person who is doing medical practice. If the person is found to be not registered to the medical council, they should seal the all chemicals, medicines, instruments and file FIR in the police.
If the person who practices pathology is not a registered medical practitioner and if it is a specific offense under any enactment legislated by any state or central government, then police has to take action. So in that sense, the police has a role to prevent, detect, investigate and prosecute those who are not acting in accordance with law.
And now if you look at what the government is doing, the government is not enforcing laws. So obviously anybody can start a laboratory and anybody is taking out reports. The person does not have the adequate qualification, does not have the adequate registrations or knows or has any technical know-how to monitor, to run the laboratory, to run the test or to interpret those readings. Yet you find them that they are opening laboratories and they are doing it and the government is doing nothing about it.
Pathology laboratory reports need to be accurate. Along with timely and correct diagnosis of disease, they make a huge difference in insurance policies and health checkups.
Pre-insurance checkups, insurance agencies, they also think that agents and many other players are there who thinks that their client should not have additional burden of that premium. And if suppose a person is diabetic and the diabetic report goes to the insurance company will either reject or increase the premium. Then they ask the laboratory owner to manipulate that report and give the normal report. But ultimately, that reflects in the more claims or over claim, and then that claims has to be ultimately paid by insurance company, and then insurance company losses are there.
For insurance purpose, MD pathologist report is required, but the signature of MD pathologist, if it can be obtained,
then the report becomes a legal valid paper. So how to stop these people who are whom we called as Sahajra? They are the signing pathologists. So this factor is allowing these laboratories.
As insurance companies must follow rule of lands, and as we have a registered medical practitioner pathologist sign on the report, all these reports before going for insurance should be signed by a pathologist. After that, whenever patient is admitted, in that case, if patient is claiming for the insurance, all these reports are to be signed by pathologist. In that case, many times malpractice occurs. It may be in absentia pathologist, or as pathologist is not there, responsible person is not there, there are chances of fabricated or adjusted reports. So insurance companies should confirm availability of pathologist and his role in reporting.
Everything in our life has become corporate, like our small shops have gone and we are going to mall to purchase so many things. So like that, there are some corporate hospitals and corporate laboratories, and they have their very big requirement to, they require large number of patients. So they make such type of some marketing gimmicks. They come out with say 100 of tests, and if you do it, and you will get it at that much concessional rate, and people go for it and do it. Actually, it's a marketing gimmick. The most of the tests, the 75% of tests are not necessary, unnecessary tests.
In the developed state of Maharashtra, over 70% of pathology laboratories are illegal, as per the records obtained by Maharashtra Association of Practicing Pathologists and Microbiologists through Right to Information Act. This is an issue of high concern, as it affects public health directly. Are these problems faced only in Maharashtra?
Sushma Swaraj, about 2 weeks back, she said in UN that India is producing doctors, whereas Pakistan is producing terrorists. But what I feel is we are promoting medical terrorism by allowing non-doctors like MSc's, PhDs and technicians to sign the medical lab reports. This scenario exists in Rajasthan as well as pan-India.
One patient just 15 days back was sent to unqualified path lab. That was patient was a lady. She was diagnosed as HIV. HIV, will you imagine who will be diagnosed as HIV? What will happen to him in his house? Again, his husband was also investigated to get investigation HIV. He was also diagnosed HIV. What will happen? Ultimately, somebody told that person, please come to Dr. Birendra Prasad. They came to me, and that was completely non-HIV. This is a situation happening with the society, and government is keeping mum.
You won't believe, but more than 90% of the labs are being run by quacks. Our Association of Practicing Pathologists, in the name of APP Haryana, we are fighting against it. And there are more than 200 members all over Haryana. We are fighting against it. We have filed cases in the court, and we have won that, and we are waiting for the implementation. So government is just sitting on those orders and they are not implementing it.
The reports of pathology tests help doctors to diagnose and treat patients correctly. Right diagnosis has a huge economic and social impact in our society. Hence, the monitoring body should be vigilant, proactive, and strict enough to penalize unethical practices. General public needs to be rightly guided.
The pathologist is sitting in the laboratory and the patient will not ask questions. I have seen my patients asking the interpretation of the reports to my receptionist, who is 12th pass, or to my technician who has just done one year course in diploma in pathology. But he refuses to come and ask the right question or whatever he wants to know from the pathologist sitting in the room waiting for him, and he's not going to charge you anything extra for it. The best part is that we also understand that most of the times the doctors do not train or monitor the reports with the patient. So all they say is do this particular test, but they don't tell the patient how to do the test or what all investigations or what all readiness is needed before doing that particular test. That job is left to the pathologist. So the doctor will write fasting and PP, but no idea what is fasting, no idea what is PP. Does the patient have to take his medicines on the day of the test, or he skips the medicines? Does he take a normal lunch? What do you mean by 2 hours? Is it 2 hours after lunch or 2 hours after starting lunch? All these questions are answered only by the pathologist, and it is a right and duty of every patient to come and ask whatever doubts he has in his mind to the pathologist.
The roles of pathologists is defined, the role of technicians is defined. So there's no question of technicians running a lab. It's always will be run by the pathologist under the supervision of the pathologist. So basically the overall, the laboratory report release, the laboratory working is under the pathologist.
First and foremost, the public or the patients should confirm that they are going to a qualified pathologist for their tests. The general practitioner should not refer their patients to such quacks. They should refer only to the qualified pathologist. And government should be very careful in implementing the law. In fact, they should be proactive, I would say.
Ultimately, this is a fight of all of us against the bad things which are going in the society. Government should penalize the illegal things which are going wrongly. Then doctors should send their patient to the proper pathologist. People should be aware, and they should work together, and they should go to the proper pathology laboratory. Media should create maximum awareness, and we should work positively so that we should stop. We can stop these illegal things. We can have a better future in the field of medicine.
The field of pathology has vast avenues. Newer generation of doctors have exciting opportunities and the chance to do even more good to society. Unethical practices, if allowed to continue, may damage public health as well as public faith in doctors. It may also discourage and deter the upcoming generations from choosing pathology. Therefore, unethical practices in pathology laboratories should be uprooted in order to protect the dignity of the pathologist and health of general public.
My message to the new generation is that pathology is changing like no other field in the medical fraternity. It is automating, the new tests are coming, new modality of testing is coming. So you require a new generation of pathologists who should be able to take care of this and carry it forward. I don't think so any other field apart from the diagnostic field is going leaps and bounds.
Pathologist is a main important person in a diagnosis. He's a diagnostician, and he's a backbone of our medicine. As a medicine means entire medical fraternity. So in a short, I can say pathologist is a consultant to consultant.